Welcome everyone to my channel that is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So if you're new to my channel, then please go ahead and hit the subscribe button and also hit the bell button besides it so that you get notified whenever I push up a new video. So students, today we are going to solve a question which was asked in CAT, as well as these are the kind of questions which are asked in CAT as well as GMAT. In fact, this is the exact question which was asked in CAT 2019. So let's understand how to solve this particular question. If you think you can give it a try, please pause the video and give this question a try. Definitely, you should give this a try because you will realize you will know that where you're getting stuck. And then when I'm trying to give you the solution or when you are watching the video, you will know that the place where you actually got stuck or where you could not solve it further. Okay, so what is the sum of 1 upon 1 into 4 plus 1 upon 2 into 5 plus 1 upon 3 into 6 plus 1 upon 4 into 7 and so on and so forth. So now, if you look at all of these fractions, the general form I can say is nothing but 1 upon n into n plus 3. Okay, and if we want to solve this or we want to write this in terms of proper fractions, you can use partial fractions and solve it further. So, taking LCM, I can write A into N plus 3A plus B into N is equals to N into N plus 3. The whole thing is again written equal to the same fraction. The denominators are same, so it's going to strike itself out. And if you look over here, we have N terms, okay? A and A plus B, which whole thing is then getting multiplied by N. But here we do not have any n terms. So I can write down a plus b is equals to 0. And 3a is a constant which is equals to 1. So a is equals to 1 by 3. Therefore, I can write down b is equals to minus 1 by 3. Because a plus b is then becoming 0. Using these values over here, I can see my general form is 1 upon 3 upon n plus 1, or rather it's minus 1 upon 3. N plus 3. Okay, so if I want to write all of these in terms of the general form, I can write 1 upon 3 upon 1 minus 1 upon 3 upon 4 plus 1 upon 3 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3 upon 5 plus 1 upon 3 upon 3 minus 1 upon 3 upon 6 plus 1 upon 3 upon 4 minus 1 upon 3 upon 7 plus the next term after 4 would be 1 upon 3 upon 5 minus 1 upon 3 upon 8, so on and so forth. Okay, so here I can take 1 upon 3 common and I have 1 minus 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 5 plus 1 upon 3 minus 1 upon 6 plus 1 upon 4 minus 1 upon 7 plus 1 upon 5 minus 1 upon 8, so on and so forth. So if you look, these terms are getting cancelled. So when you are actually going ahead, you will realize that almost all of these terms are getting cancelled. Okay, so I am actually left with 1 upon 3, just 1 minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3. That's it. Okay, so if you want to solve this particular further, students, if you're liking the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button. That gives me tremendous amount of encouragement in doing these kind of videos. Okay, so now when you solve this particular further, also sorry to interrupt again, but at the end of this video, I'm going to push up a question which is of the similar form, and you're going to solve that question and write the answer in the comment section. Okay, I'll read your answers and let you know whether you're right or wrong. In case your answer is wrong, please come back to this video and watch it again to see where actually you went wrong. Okay, so here we'll take the LCM. We have 6, 6 plus 3 plus 2. So that's sorry, this is 1 upon 3. So 1 upon 3, 11 upon 6, that becomes 11 upon 18. So out of our answers, option C is the correct option. Okay, students, a lot of you all have asked me about any particular book to refer when you need to, when you are preparing for these kind of entrances. Then I can recommend a book which is written by Mr. R.S. Agarwal. That book is amazing for your concepts as well as if you need a lot of practice while solving these kind of, while preparing for CAT or GMAT or any of the entrance exams. Okay, so the link of that is been given in my description. Please go ahead and check it out. Okay. Also, if you have any particular topic with which you are not at all comfortable, please feel free to tell me about it in the comment section. Or actually, I would prefer if you could email me, because there are times when, you know, a comment gets missed by me. So if you have any particular doubt, I would request you to email me that doubt or that particular topic. I will try to make a video of that as soon as possible. Okay, so now coming to the question, what is the sum of 1 upon 1 into 3 plus 2 into 4 plus 1 upon 3 into 5 plus 1 upon 4 into 6, so on and so forth. Students, before signing off, I want to tell you all a tip of this particular partial fractions. Okay, this is generally very handy when it comes to any of these kind of sums which are very often asked in these entrance exams. So if you don't know how to do a partial fraction or how to solve a partial fraction, please let me know. So, because that is something which I have not made a video of as yet. I will try to make a video of that also. But if I know that, you know, people do not know, I will try to make it as soon as possible. So, yeah, this is one thing which you need to know to understand or to solve these kind of sequences so that, you know, you can get to the answer very, very quickly. Please understand, a lot of students try to, you know, first find the values of actual denominators. Don't do all of that, okay? You, when you see a correlation between the two numbers, you have to understand that is the time partial fraction will come into help for you, okay? So that's it for now. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.